In 2018, I shared with you a complete series of Ultimaker Cura
that resulted being very successful, accumulating more than 121,000 views, what is insane.
Along that series, the Cura Advanced Settings 2018,
we did run through different versions of the software, starting in the version 3.2.1 all the way up till the 3.4.1 in the last episode.
Despite the constant update, those versions are right now obsolete with the recent launch of the Cura 4.2.1. That's the reason I've decided to launch this new series that I'm gonna name in a very original way.
Cura Advanced Settings 2019.
The structure will be very similar to the series launched in 2018, but including the new features of the software. So that's why I'm gonna start from zero in this episode, installing the software and setting up a 3D printer and the filament to start making some prints. But before starting, be sure to click here in the subscribe button and to ring that bell to be notified when new cool stuff is uploaded. If you do it, it will help me creating new content and growing the channel to reach more special viewers like you. Alright, so first step, we'll go to ultimaker.com.
We'll click in software, download for free, choose the version for your operating system, and after a few seconds, we'll be able to open the installer.
Once the download of the file is complete,
we'll then run the installer clicking next, 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 and here we have the software already installed.
If it's the first time you install it, you may not have any 3D printer or filament set up yet, so assuming that, I'm gonna create a new 3D printer and filament that we're gonna use in this episode and the rest of episodes of this series. In this case, for 3D printer,
I'm going to be using our custom built Architects 3DP i3, a great quality Prusa i3 style DIY 3D printer for 200 bucks that we built in a complete series here at Architects 3DP.
And I recommend you to check out clicking in the top right corner or in the link in the description. We're gonna be using it via USB. So first step, we'll connect the USB cable both to the 3D printer as well as our PC. For filament, I'm gonna use this brand new green PLA filament from Gitek
that they sent me a while ago. So first I'm gonna take it out of the box and out of the protective plastic.
Now I'm gonna preheat our Architects 3DP i3.
And once it reaches the 200 degrees in the nozzle, I'm gonna proceed and load the filament.
I'm gonna make a quick print of the Marvin
with the optimized settings I already have to see how this filament and printer perform with a good configuration. By the way, as always, you can download the 3D Marvin STL file from the link in the description. As you can see, the printer, as always, did a great job, since the quality of this fast print is just fantastic.
Once everything is set up, I'm gonna go back to Cura.
And as I said, I'm going to create a 3D printer and filament
that are the ones that we're gonna be using in this series.
As you can see, I already have the Architects 3DP i3 created, so I'm gonna create a new printer that I'm gonna name the Architects 3DP i3 2019. For that, we'll click here or go to Settings, Printer, Manage Printers, here we'll click on Add, and now we'll have to open the second tab. Here we have a bunch of 3D printer bands where we can choose from.
But since we custom built this printer,
we're gonna go to the Custom tab, we'll select Custom FFF Printer, and we're gonna name it Architects 3DP i3 2019, and then click Add. Here we'll set it up with our machine specifications. In our case, 252mm for the x-axis, 239mm for the y-axis, and 202mm for the height. The build plate shape is rectangular. We do have a heated bed. For the G-code flavor, we'll choose Marlin, and then for the print head settings, I'm gonna fill them with our dimensions.
If you want more details, you can check out the video where we did these calculations clicking in the link in the description.
Now in the extruder tab, we're gonna select a 0.4mm nozzle size. For filament, we'll set 1.75mm and we'll leave the rest at 0. Last but not least, we're gonna modify the start and end G-code. I'm gonna copy the configuration I did after building this printer, and you can check out in the link I mentioned before.
You can just copy the code I have on screen if you build this 3D printer together with me, following the Build the Best DIY 3D Printer series.
Alright, so now that we have finished the configuration of the 3D printer, we're gonna create a profile for this green PLA from Gitek. By the way, before anything, here you'll have to choose the 3D printer we just created. To create the material, we'll click here, here, and here in Manage Materials. As you can see, there are a bunch of filament brands as well, but Gitek does not appear. So I'm going to create a custom brand that I will call 00_architects3dp, so it will appear at the beginning of the list. Here I will save all the new materials to avoid confusions in the future. We'll click here in Create, and right next, we're gonna set up all the files of this PLA. First, for display name, I'm going to write Gitek Green PLA, the brand will be 00_architects3dp, the material type PLA, the color green, and we'll choose a similar tone from here. We can let the density as 1.24 and the diameter to 1.75, as it is by default. For the cost of the filament, if we go to Amazon, we can see that it costs $19.99, so that's what we're gonna set here. And the weight is 1 kilo, so we'll set it to 1000 grams. Then in the Print Settings tab, I'm going to tune these settings a little bit. The print temperature is okay at 200 degrees. For the build plate, I'm gonna set it down to 40 degrees. Also the retraction distance to 3 mm and the retraction speed to 30 mm per second. Finally, I'm gonna lower the fan speed to 30%.
As something is not correct in the milling configuration of my printer, I know that I get the best result with an 87% flow with this filament.
So I'm gonna use the description box to write this note, so I won't forget it when I use it again. Once done, as you can see here in the left, we have the new brand we created, that is 00_architects3dp, and inside the PLA subtab, we have the custom Gitek Green PLA filament we just created. Now we can close this configuration tab, since we have everything set up to start with this new series.
In the next episode, we'll explore the new interface of Cura 4.2.1
before starting with the custom settings section, so stay tuned for the next episode of this series coming to the channel.
Finally, I just wanted to ask you to subscribe to Architects3dp if you still haven't, hit the like button, leave a comment, and share this video so more people will be able to enjoy with this project. And as always, a special shout out to our Patreon supporters for making this channel possible. If you want to join them and support the channel as well, you can do it navigating to patreon.com/architects3dp, clicking here in the top right corner, or in the link in the description. Okay guys, so as always, see you in the next video!